We live in a film society.
Hey everybody, it's the Slippery Rock Film Society here to bring you a new installment of Film Society Goes to the Movies. What are we seeing this time, Annika?
We are seeing Joker today.
We have in the car with us Rob, Taylor.
So, what are you guys excited for Joker, Daniel? Let's start with you.
So, I've already seen Joker. I saw it when everyone was on fall break because I was here alone, so I had something to do. I won't give my full opinion just yet, but I really like Joaquin Phoenix, so obviously excitement for him. I'm looking forward to more continuations of the Batman story.
How about you, Annika?
I don't really know a lot about Batman or whatnot, but I do like superhero movies, and I know that Joker's not a superhero, but I'm kind of looking forward to seeing like his side of things, I guess, and a background for his character.
How about you?
I'm excited because we live in a society, and I heard that's what it's about.
I agree, we do live in a society.
We live in a society, yeah.
How many memes can we get in one video? Let's find out.
Yeah, I'm excited because of the memes. That's it.
Honestly.
All right.
Got out a Joker, everybody. So, like I said before, this was my second time seeing it. I think I did enjoy it more this time. Originally, I think my main issue was that I really liked all the acting, and I really liked the cinematography and the atmosphere and everything. But I don't think the writing was too spectacular. I think the script could have been a bit better, but watching it a second time around, there were some more subtle things that I noticed, and some, like, motifs that I could appreciate more.
I thought that it was shot really nice.
I agree. I don't know the name of the cinematographer, but I'll have to look it up. The color palette, I think, works really well.
Yeah, I thought the color palette really went well with, like, the era they were trying to get to. Like, a 50s-60s era.
Yeah.
60s era.
I thought it was the 70s.
Yeah, I thought it was
the
70s.
I guess it's the 70s.
I guess it's
like,
70s, yeah.
The yellows.
Advanced a little bit to be,
yeah.
Like, the 60s.
Yeah,
but, like,
plus the cars, yeah.
Like,
it would probably
the
be
the
70s.
Yeah. But yeah, I personally really liked the acting. Excuse me.
Need some help.
I think I do. Especially from the Joaquin Phoenix, is that his name?
Mm-hmm.
I think he did a really good job in that role.
So when they went on like stage and everything, and they brought Joker on, and they bring him on stage, and they can tell he's a bit crazy, and like he sort of just starts like going off on stage, and like you would think that they would have like hurried up the police more quickly and security. That's sort of like, I was like, you should probably be calling security.
Yeah.
Like, now.
But, you know, like, before the guy got shot?
Yeah, and I was just like, this
the
guy's
old lady, like, that he, like, made out with, like, she was just sitting there after it happened, like,
and
I was like, get off the stage!
Oh,
like, you're sitting next to him!
Oh, yeah.
Speaking of that, like, the whole scene of him on the talk show, I think one of my issues with the movie is that it suffers from too many ending syndrome. So what I mean is, like, this is also a problem I have with the last Lord of the Rings movie. So there are multiple places near, like, the last sequence where the movie could have ended. So there's, like, the shot of him talking to the TV camera, like, straight in his face. And, like, it, like, pans out and shows all the, like, TV things. So, like, that could have been an interesting place to end. The shot of just him looking out from the police car could have been a good ending. So the ending of him, like, where it ends, and I think you're supposed to interpret it as, like, he was a mental patient this whole time, and you're not supposed to know, like, what parts of his story are real or not. I don't like that ending as much as where it could have gone instead, basically.
I think another ending it could have had was whenever he was standing, like, on top of the police car and everyone's, like, cheering.
Yeah, exactly.
I expected that to be the end, and then it wasn't.
I mean, it fades to black, so...
Yeah. Alright, what was everybody's favorite scene in the movie?
I think my favorite scene, personally, is probably just the talk show segment. Just because I think that's when everything comes to a head, and it's when the tension is at its highest. And showing Joaquin Phoenix, what's his name, Arthur Fleck, showing him at, like, his whole breaking point, I thought was the most interesting part.
What? How about you, Rob?
I think generally I liked his acting and all, but I liked just the cinematography and all, like, the widescape shots, especially of, like, the matte paintings in the film, I thought were really nicely done and subtle. So I enjoyed, like, the matte paint shots, which is a little weird, but, like, yeah.
Do you have a favorite scene?
I liked whenever he first walked out onto the stage for the talk show, and I thought that just, like, kind of showed how, like, crazy he is, because, like, I don't know, it just made me uncomfortable. So
all his dance, yeah, his dancing was, is so,
and, like,
funny.
His body was,
oh,
like,
yeah. Yeah.
I was like,
so, another thing I liked was, like, it wasn't, like, when he was putting on, like, his shoes or taking them off, like, it was, like, an image of his back and his shoulder.
Yeah.
And like, I know this because I'm a pretty scrawny dude, but oh my god, it's just really hard to look at.
Yeah.
It really is a little bit, like...
His dancing scene, though, I appreciated that more this time, just in context with, like... If you notice, like, when he dances, I think is interesting. Like, after he kills the Wall Street dudes and he, like, goes to the bathroom and dances, the score was really great in that scene. And the cinematography, how that, like, bathroom dance scene was shot was really cool, I thought.
A note about the music. I particularly noticed that I really liked where the music was at, how the music was at, like, when his mom was going into the ambulance.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
The score in general, I think, is pretty good.
Yeah, like, I really liked the happy song that they played, like, throughout it.
Or Send in the Clouds, or...
Yeah,
or
like, that one, and then, like, the That's Life song.
Yeah.
That, I think, they did, like, a really good job for it.
Yeah, I agree.
I think that really added a lot to the movie.
Yeah, the music, it like, I know it's in a lot of modern movies that the music, when they're introduced in the movie... It feels somewhat, like, cliched in the same, but in this movie, I did feel like it fit the tone really well, and at points, it did not feel, like, overly dramatic. It felt, like, right with how the tone felt during the scenes. One scene I did, like, have a bit of, I don't know if it's just sort of a nitpick, but when they introduced the scene with the, where he basically not really realizes, but when the audience realizes that the woman he had, like, sex with and was having a relationship with was, like, not actually having a relationship at all with him. I thought that when they, like, did, like, the little flashback thing, I didn't think that was really needed.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think we kind of, yeah, we could get
that. Yeah, I thought it was...
She was, like, your art, Arthur?
Yeah.
She's,
yeah,
like, your name's Arthur. It's, like... Okay, I get it.
That
but at first, whenever, like, I didn't get it at first because
yeah.
I'm stupid. Whenever he, like, showed up in clown makeup and then they started having sex, I was like, okay, first of all, if
Arthur
he showed up after he was, like, stalking me.
Arthur is not an attractive man,
yeah.
And I
yes.
don't think anyone finds stalking attractive.
And then with clown makeup, and then just bangs on my door, opens it, and kisses me, I'm not gonna be like, yeah.
All right, everyone. So, do you have any final thoughts on Joker or a score that you'd like to give it?
I think it was a decent movie. I wouldn't say it's my favorite. There are things about it that I liked. I liked, the theme of, like, classism. I thought was really good. I liked just kind of, like, social awareness, the difference between, like, the poor and the rich. With the mental illness part, I thought that, like, the beginning of the movie was kind of, like, oh, mental illness, edgy, cool kind of thing. But, like, towards, like, the end of it, it that kind of, like, strayed away from that. And I kind of liked, showed more of, like, a, almost like a reality kind of thing. That, like, you know, it's not really, like, a fun kind of thing, I guess, like, towards the end. And honestly, if I were going to rate it, I'd put it at, like, is that out of 10?
Yeah.
Is that out of 10? I'd probably put it at, like, 7.5, honestly.
Mm-hmm. I personally did enjoy the film. I really did like the cinematography, and the overall acting in the film was fantastic. So if I really had to give it, like, a score out of 10, I'd probably give it a 7 out of 10.
I liked it. I mean, this was the first, like, Joker movie I've never seen, like, any Batman or anything like that before. So, like, I didn't know what to expect. But, like, I liked it. We live in a society.
Agreed.
Also, he probably ended the movie with, like, 18 different concussions because he smacked his head so fucking much. 6.5.
Yeah, on my initial viewing, I was going more for a 6. Though, like I said, I did appreciate it more this time. So, I'm probably gonna change that to a very light 7. Again, I think it's been overrated a bit just because it's well acted and it's well presented. I don't think it's, like, the best written movie ever. I think Taxi Driver, which is, like, clearly a big inspiration, is, like, a much better movie. But this, it clearly wears its influences on its sleeve, but it does its own original thing, and since Joaquin Phoenix is really great in it, I think it's worth a watch, and a light 7 would be my score, so yeah. What do you get when you live in a society with a mentally ill loner and a society that treats you like trash? You get an incel like Joker. But anyway, we'll see you around next time. Peace.